putting a bailador to rest, that's a tall order, first of one. You might wonder about the funny name, which is inspired by dancer, the equivalent in old or also old per six. Bailador is dancer in Spanish, and a particular one at that, usually spelled bailar and devoted to flamenco, castanets here. Be that as it may, it gives the user a way to create a REST API in per six pretty fast. And it comes with all the goodies. You know, concurrence, functional flavor, everything that's preferred in our per six problems. You see, we have the problem right here. It's using Emacs, which is my preferred editor. And you might wonder what's a REST API. It's a programming interface that uses HTTP commands and status codes and URIs as a way of referring to resources. You want to call a function with a changing state, then you can use HTTP order get. That's what you do when you bring up a web page in your browser. Actually, what you're doing is get the URL you're typing. You want to create something using a REST API, use put, a very basic REST API would include those two commands. That's what we are going to do here. We have a put, we have a get. What we are going to do is a very basic casino API. We deal cards, we put them into a deck, and we get them randomly when there are enough. There is no artificial intelligence, there is no machine learning, there is no error checking, just a very basic API. Don't do this at home, boys. This is just an example. Real APIs are much more complicated. Let's fire this up. So we have it right here, right? Okay. So we run it with Perl 6, the number of the program, which is dl.perl 6. And then what we're doing is we enter into the development dance floor. Actually, Bailey right here is what's doing all the thing. So right now we are dancing. And we have two commands. We have a put and a get command. The put command, what it's doing is putting things into the deck. For instance, we are going to insert some letter, some card here. For instance, five of diamonds. And you see, what it's doing here is extracting a part of the URL. You see, this part, this regular expression, will correspond to this 5D we have here. Then whatever is in there is inserted into the card variable. And then we do something funny here. We extract the last letter of that. In this case, it will be a D. And we are going to check whether there is an equivalent for that. In this case, it's a D. The D in this hash we have defined here is equivalent to a diamond, right? Then we take out the last part of the card, we add the suite, and we do here some funny thing which is peculiar to Perl 6. Cards is gonna be a set, because actually you don't care about the order. So arrays have an order, you have this one first, this one second. Cards, I mean a deck, doesn't really have an order. So we are going to use a set to define it. What do you do with set? You join them. This is U, which is a mathematical symbol for union. Then we add the new card to the set. And then we finally use JSON, which is, you know, it's a very usual method for returning things in REST APIs. And this JSON has this key card and then the value of the card. That is what we see here. Actually, the problem is that, you know, JSON is not so good with nice Unicode characters, but, you know, that's what it is. We can help it. If we do that on the browser, of course, we could see it in some beautiful. Actually, we can do that later on. Okay, so we can insert several cards there. For instance, 6S, and also let's say. An 8 of hearts. Okay, so now we have three cards on the deck. You see that here we have like a log. We could do that more beautifully, but what we see here is that everything is going all right. And then we can extract something from the deck. Let's say card, and just simply this address, right? You see, we have extracted the 6. We also get this in the log here. And actually, Carl, when you do nothing with it, you don't insert any command or anything like that, it's like, you know, like doing the URL. Like it's the same if you do something like wget or anything. Like, it's going to be kind of different. You're going to have it on a file. It's going to be called by default index.html, but index.html is going to have exactly the same. If you go to a browser, which I don't have now, you will find exactly the same thing. And basically, that's it. Thank you very much for listening.